Simon says subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications.
In this section of the course, we're going to take a look at how we can share, export, and print our presentations. And we're going to start out in this lesson by talking about sharing. Now, these days, where teams can be spread across different offices and different parts of the world, it's really important to be able to share presentations and other types of documents efficiently. And in the olden days, the only way to really share a PowerPoint presentation was to attach it to an email and send it out to a distribution list, for example. Now, that wasn't the most efficient way of working. Because when you send out a presentation as an attachment in an email, which it's worth noting you can still do that if you really want to, remember you're sending a copy of that presentation. So any changes that your colleague makes to that presentation once they've opened it from the attachment won't be saved back to the original. If they do make changes, they'd have to reattach it to an email, send it back to you, and then you'd have to resave that file as a new version or over the top of the original to incorporate those changes. Now we have a much more efficient way of working when it comes to sharing. So if I want to share this presentation with some colleagues, I have a couple of different ways I can go about this. In the top right-hand corner, we have a share button. Now, if I click this, it's going to open up a pane on the right-hand side where I can invite people. Now, if I'm sharing this with colleagues within my organization where we're all on the same network, I can simply start to type in their name and it will pull up a list of them underneath and I can go through and select their names. If you're sharing with colleagues who are outside of your network, then you'll need to type in their full email address. And remember, over on the right-hand side, we have access to our Outlook contacts from here as well. So you can just go in, select your address book, and then choose your colleagues from here. Once I have a list of invitees, I can then choose the level of access that I want to give them to this presentation. So, do I want them to be able to edit or only view? Well, I'm happy for them to edit, and then I can add in a message. Once I'm happy with my settings, I can simply click on the share button. And what this will do is it will send an email out with a link back to this presentation. So when they click on the link, they're working on the original presentation, not a copy. Now, before we click on share, I just want to highlight another option that we have in this pane right at the bottom, and that is get a sharing link. Now, this differs from what we were just looking at in that from here, we can generate either an edit link or a view only link. So if I want to create an edit link, which means they're able to edit this document, I can click and it's going to give me this link. I can then copy the link and I can either paste that into an email or maybe into something like Teams, SharePoint, or another collaboration app. Now, sometimes using a sharing link as opposed to inviting everybody individually is a lot more efficient. It really depends on how many people you want to share this presentation with. So in general, my rule is that if I'm sharing this with less than 5 people, it's reasonably straightforward for me to just invite them from here. If I want to send it to the entire company or a larger group of people, I'll normally get a sharing link and then paste that into an Outlook email, and I can then use an Outlook distribution list to send that out. Now, let's click on share. As soon as I do that, it's going to generate that email and send it off to myself and Jen. And you can see it's added both of these people underneath, so I can see from here also who I've shared this document with. And I can also see what level of permission they have. If I decide at any stage that I want to change, for example, Jen's access from can edit to can view, I can simply right-click on her name and notice I can remove her entirely if I want to take away her access, or I can change her permission to can view. So really nice and straightforward. The other way that we can share a presentation is through the file menu. We have a share page just here as well, and 3 options. The first one is share with people, and this is going to just reopen that same pane. The other options that we have in here are send an email. So as I said, you can still attach presentations to emails if that's what you prefer. But remember, when you send as an attachment, it's going to be a copy that you're sending. Now, notice here, I'm getting a message that says this presentation is too large to be sent as an email attachment. And that's because this presentation contains a lot of media. So if your presentation is too large, you could either maybe try and zip it to compress it, or you could consider saving it to a cloud location. So maybe something like Google Drive or OneDrive and sharing it through there instead. But for very small presentations, you can still do things like send them as attachments. You could also send a link. So this is just going to send a link out to this presentation, which is very similar to the link we generated previously. We could even, at this stage, convert this presentation to a PDF and send that, an XPS, which is basically Microsoft's version of PDF, or we could send as an internet fax. The final option we have is to present online. Now, this option actually isn't available in PowerPoint 2021. You can see there the button is grayed out. This option does require you to have a subscription to Microsoft 365. So those are all of the different methods that you can use to share a presentation.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.